Hello dear students, welcome to all. I am Mrs. Sujata Tarle from KK Wagh Polytechnic, Nasik. In this video, we are going to discuss about some basic concept of statistics. Learning outcomes. After watching this video, the students will be able to identify the types of the data and to find the mean for the different types of the data. So let us start with what is meant by the statistics. Statistics is the science of collecting, organizing, analyzing, summarizing, and interpreting the numerical data and then making the valid conclusion on the basis of that data. In short, statistics is nothing but the collection of data and then analyze that data to draw the valid conclusion. As statistics is a collection of data, so this data is classified into the three types. First one is raw data. The numerical figures and the facts obtained from a survey is called as the raw data. That means when some information is collected randomly and it presented directly without any analysis, so such a type of the data is called as raw data. For example, here in first example, we have given that the marks of 7 students in mathematics. And in second example, we have given that the height of 11 players of the team. In both the examples, we have given that only the numerical values. So it is the raw data. Second is ungrouped data. The data is collected but not sorted into any group or the classes, then it is called as ungrouped data. In ungrouped data, we have given that the observation and its corresponding frequency in tabular form. For each individual observations, we have given that its corresponding frequency. For example, the first one, the ages of workers in a certain factory are given in the table. Here we have given that age in year and the number of workers. That means observation and its corresponding frequency. There are total 5 workers whose age is 19. There are total 10 workers whose age is 21. There are total 13 workers whose age is 25. In this way, we have given that the age and the workers in tabular form. Similarly, in the second example, we have given that the marks of the students in certain examination. We have given that the marks and number of students. That means observation and its frequency. So such a type of the data is called as ungrouped data. Third type is group data. The data which is classified into the different classes after the collection, then it is called as group data. In group data, we have given that the class interval and its corresponding frequency in tabular form. For example, first one, the shoe size of 30 students are given in the table. In this example, we have given that the shoe size of 30 students in group form. The first group is 2 to 4, second is 5 to 7, and third is 8 to 10. These groups are called as the class interval or the classes. Whereas this 2 is called as the lower class limit and this 4 is called as upper class limit. Also given that the number of students. This number of students means the frequency of this group. There are total 11 students in the group 2 to 4. There are total 9 students in the group 5 to 7. There are total 10 students in the group 8 to 10. Similarly, in the second example, we have given that the height of the students in group form and also given that the number of students. Here, the groups or the class intervals are 145 to 150, 150 to 155, and 155 to 160. And also given that its corresponding frequency, that means the number of students. In this way, in this both the examples, the data is given in classified form. That means the data is given in group form. So it is the group data. But note that there is a difference in their class interval. Here in the first example, the class intervals are 2 to 4, 5 to 7, and 8 to 10. That means there is a difference of 1 in between the upper class limit of the first class and the lower class limit of the second class. That means these groups or the class intervals are not given in continuous way. So these class intervals are called as discrete class intervals or the discontinuous class interval. Whereas in second example, the class intervals are 145 to 150, 150 to 155, and 155 to 160. There is no any difference between this upper class limit of the first class and the lower class limit of the second class. That means these groups are given in continuous way. So these class intervals are called as continuous class interval. That means this group data is again classified into the two types according to their class interval or the classes. The first type is discrete classes. It is also called as inclusive method. In this method, the lower class limit and upper class limit both are included. Whereas in second type, that is the continuous classes, it is also called as exclusive method. In this, the lower class limit is included, but the upper class limit is excluded. For example, if there is observation 150, then 150 lies in which group? Either first group or the second group? So the answer is, for the first group, 145 to 150, 150 is the upper class limit, so it is excluded. So 150 is not lying in this group. And for the second class, 150 to 155, here this 150 is the lower class limit and it is included. So the 150, this observation lies in this second group, that is 150 to 155. In this way, this group data is classified into these two types. Here it is the quick review of the types of data. The first one is raw data. In raw data, we have given that the observation. Second type is ungrouped data. In ungrouped data, we have given that the observation and its corresponding frequency. And the third type, that is the group data. In group data, we have given that the class interval and its frequency, where these class intervals are either continuous class interval or the discrete class interval. Next one is the measures of central tendency. The measures of central tendency are mean, median, and mode. But in this video, we are going to concentrate on mean. Here, mean is the arithmetical average of all the observations in the given data is known as its arithmetic mean or simply mean. This mean is denoted by x bar and it represents the average of the data. So how to find the mean? Now for the raw data, the mean x bar is equal to sum of all observations divided by total number of observations. That means this x bar is equal to summation of xi upon n. It is a formula for the mean for the raw data. Second is ungrouped data. To find the mean, we have to prepare the table like this for the ungrouped data. Here in first column, write down the observation, that is xi. In second column, write down the frequency, that is fi. And in third column, we have to find out this fi into xi. And at the last, just taken out its sum, that is summation of fi and summation of fi into xi. So the mean for the ungrouped data is equal to summation of fi into xi upon summation of fi. Third one, for the group data. To find the mean for the group data, we have to prepare the table like this. In first column, we have to write down the class interval. In second column, write down the class marks xi. This class mark is nothing but the mid value of this class interval. In third column, write down the given frequency, that is fi. And at the last, just taken out the multiplication, that is fi into xi. This is fi into xi. And at the last, taken out the sum, that is summation of fi into summation of fi into xi. So the mean x bar is equal to summation of fi into xi upon summation of fi, where this xi is the class mark of the classes, that means the mid value of the classes. Now let us discuss some example. The first one is calculate the mean of the following data: 7, 40, 9, 12 and 8. Here in first example, we have given that only the numerical values, so it is the raw data. So the solution is, the formula for the mean x bar is equal to, for the raw data, formula is sum of all observations divided by total number of observation. That is x bar is equal to summation of xi upon n. So it is equal to, we just taken out the sum of all observations, that is 7 plus 14 plus 9 plus 12 plus 8 and divide by 5. As there are total 5 observations, so divide by 5, which is equal to 50 upon 5 and which is equal to 10. So mean of the given raw data is equal to 10. Second example, calculate the mean for the following data. In second example, we have given that xi and fi, that means observation and its corresponding frequency. So it is the ungrouped data. So to find the solution, here we have to prepare the table like this. In first column, write down the xi, that means the observation. In second column, write down the fi, that is the frequency, which are given in the examples, observation and frequency. Both are given in the examples. We have to find out this fi into xi. Just taken out the multiplication, this fi into xi is 1 into 3, 3, 3 into 4, 12, 7 into 5, 35, 5 into 6, 30, 2 into 7, 14, and 2 into 8, 16. And at the last, just taken out sum. The sum of this frequency, that is summation of fi, is equal to 20, and summation of this fi into xi is equal to 110. So the formula for the mean x bar is equal to summation of fi into xi upon summation of fi, which is equal to 110 upon 20, which is equal to 5.5. So mean for the given ungrouped data is equal to 5.5. Third example, calculate the mean for the following data. Here in third example, we have given that the marks and the number of students. These marks are given in group form, so it is the group data. Now to find the mean for the group data, we have to prepare the table like this. In first column, write down the class intervals which are given in the example. In second column, we have to find out the class marks, that is xi. This class mark is nothing but the mid value of this class interval. So for the class 0 to 10, the class mark is 0 plus 10 upon 2. Just taken out the mid value of this, which is equal to 5. Similarly, for the class 10 to 20, the class mark is 10 plus 20 upon 2, which is equal to 15. In this way, find out the class mark for the remaining classes. In third column, write down the frequency, which is given in the example, that is 3, 5, 8, 3 and 1. It is the value of fi. And at the last, just take out multiplication, fi into xi. Fi into xi. 3 into 5, 15, 5 into 15, 75, 8 into 25, 200, 3 into 35, 105, and 1 into 45, that is equal to 45. At the last, just taken out the sum. The sum of all frequency, that is summation of fi is equal to 20. And the summation of fi into xi is equal to 440. So mean, that is x bar is equal to, formula is summation of fi xi upon summation of fi, which is equal to 440 upon 20, which is equal to 22. So mean for the given group data is equal to 22. Thank you.